allow me first to appreciate all the nurses and to congratulate them for a job well done on COVID matters. It is not easy. I happen to have a sister who is a nurse, and therefore I know it is not easy. And allow me to say happy Mashujaa Day, because in my view, you are the Shujaas of this country at the moment. So thank you very much for inviting me for this webinar. I'll be talking about integrity, and I'll make it a bit more participative so that you're able to enjoy the session. And I'll just start by probably defining what integrity is. And many times people have defined integrity in different ways. I've had people say that integrity is when you do something the same way when people are looking and when they are not looking. Others have said integrity is when you are consistent. But I want to define integrity in a different way, which is really the real thing. So allow me to start by defining integrity of a person. And integrity of a person is really a matter of their word. Nothing more, nothing less. So when you talk about integrity, you are talking about the word of that person. And when you talk about integrity, it is also good for us to know that integrity has everything to do with anything that we see. For example, a car has integrity, a chair has integrity, because if a car has no integrity, then we say this car is not moving. So in other words, when you talk about integrity, we are talking about being whole, we are talking about being complete, we are talking about being unbroken, we are talking about being sound, we are talking about being in perfect condition. So we need to understand integrity in that aspect. That actually when you talk about integrity, you're saying, if a chair has no integrity, it will not hold you. So the integrity of a person, therefore, is about their word. And therefore the question then is, what constitutes the word of a person? Word, W-O-R-D. What constitutes your word? Because that is what integrity is all about. Now, your word constitutes six key things. Yeah? Six key things constitute your word. The first one is what you say. What you say is your word. So whatever you say you will do, then becomes your word. Yeah? Whatever is requested of you becomes your word, unless you say you will not do it. For example, you find sometimes in an office, somebody can ask you, I said, my sister is a nurse, so I have a few, I know a few things because I stayed in a house before. Sometimes someone is caught up and they want someone to, you know, do the duty on their behalf or something. Now, if someone tells you that I'll do it for you, they don't do it for you, they are out of integrity. So integrity is your word. What is it that you said you will do? Yeah? What is it that you've been requested to do? The second thing that constitutes your word is what you know. That which you know to do or you know not to do, and you don't do it or you do it, then you will be out of integrity. So there are those things that we know we should do. I'm sure even in your own life, in your own homes, in your own offices, there are those things that you know you should do. So if there's something that you know you should do and you do not do it, you are out of integrity. Yeah? If there's something that you know you should not do and you go ahead and do it, then you are out of integrity. That is number two, what constitutes your word. Number three, what constitutes your word is what is expected of you. The unexpressed requests of you. That is what is expected of you. For example, if I come to a hospital or to a dispensary, there is what a patient expects of you. Yeah? Even though they have not requested of you. Maybe you'll be telling me as we continue, what is it that you think your customers expect of you? So whatever is expected of you, whatever you are requested to do or not to do by anyone, if you have a workable relationship with them and you do not do it, unless you have said you will not be doing it, then you're out of integrity. That is the third thing that constitutes your word. Now, the fourth thing that constitutes your word is what you say is so. What you say is so. In other words, when you've given your word to others, yeah, your word includes being held accountable. You know, I've had people arguing in many circles that we did not agree on anything. We just spoke. I was joking. You've had even people in this nation saying we didn't sign any agreement or anything. As long as you have spoken a word, what you say is so, you need to do it. If you don't do it, then you are out of integrity. Number five, what constitutes your word is what you stand for. What is it that you stand for as a person? Yeah. What is it that people say about your life? Yeah. What can you be counted on unquestionably? And that can either be because you've declared it to yourself or to people, and you have allowed people to believe that you stand for that. So maybe the question you need to ask yourself is, what is it that you stand for? Even in the offices, there's many times people will tell you, I know you stand for this. Why are you now saying the other thing? Now, if you stand for something and you don't do what you stand for, you don't speak out and you stand for something, then you're out of integrity. The sixth thing that makes your word is the moral, the ethical, and the legal standards. Yeah? Which you have, we all know the moral aspects as we work, as doctors, as nurses. There are those moral issues, there are those ethical issues, and there are those legal standards. So if you do not do any of those, then you are out of integrity. Now, we've said that integrity constitutes your word. So what is integrity? Integrity is when you honor your word. So the key word here is you are a person of integrity if you honor your word. And to honor your word, it takes two things. Either you keep your word and on time, yeah? You're keeping your word and on time. And if you do not keep your word, then you let the person know that you're not be keeping your word, yeah? And you let them know when you will be keeping your word in the future, if you're gonna keep it or not, and then deal with the mess that you have created. Then you can say you are a person of integrity. In other words, you say you are a person of integrity if you keep your word and you keep your word on time. Let me give an example. Many times, especially for parents, you can tell your children, I'll be taking you out or I'll be taking you to swimming on Sunday. Then come Saturday night or Sunday morning, you just tell them, I'm not taking you. And you don't tell them why you are not taking them and when you're going to be taking them. Then you're out of integrity. But if you call them and tell them, hey, I'll not be taking you out, but I'll be taking you next week because of this and this, then you have integrity. So integrity is when you honor your word. And honoring your word is keeping your word and on time. Yeah? And I must say, I'm very pleased most of you are on by 7:30, so you keep time. Because you can be out of integrity with time. You'll still be a person of integrity if you don't keep time, but you call the moderator and let them know that you'll not be keeping time at what time you'll be coming. For example, your president exhibited integrity because he was able to call the moderator and tell them that I'll be late, but I'll be joining you. That is what we call integrity. Now, I want to ask you a question from what I have discussed so far. Now, from the six issues that I've said that define your word, what you say you do, what you know, what is expected of you, what you say is so, what you stand for, and the moral, the ethical, and the legal standards. Which one do you think you are likely to be out of integrity? I would want us to type so that we talk. Which one among those six, as a person, do you think for some reason, once in a while, you're out of integrity? Is it about what you say? Is it what you know? Is it what is expected of you? Is it what you say is so? Or is it what you stand for? Or is it the moral, the ethical, and the legal standards? So when you say that you have integrity, therefore, and when you say you are honoring your word, it is important for you to know that if you're not going to keep your word, then as soon as you know you will not be keeping your word, you let the person know and clean up any mess, as I said. Yeah? And it is important for us to understand that, especially in self-leadership, because all of us are leaders in our own way, integrity is key. In fact, I keep saying leadership without integrity is really no leadership at all. Because you can imagine a leader who cannot keep their word. You can imagine a parent who cannot keep their word. You can imagine a doctor who cannot keep their word. A lecturer who can't keep their word. A lecturer tells you, like, because I'm one, they'll come to class at 8. They don't show up at all, and they don't tell you they are not coming, or they show up at 9 when you guys are gone, you know? So integrity is everything. Now, the other key thing that is important for us to understand is that sometimes people do cost-benefit analysis about their word. That is why you hear people sometimes going back and saying, I didn't mean what I said, which is out of integrity. Because they are trying to do a cost-benefit analysis, yeah? And I want to bring it to your attention that the best time to do your cost-benefit analysis is when you are considering giving your word. In other words, you should do your cost-benefit analysis before you give your word. Because when you give your word, as long as you've given your word, you must keep that word. If you have to remain a person with integrity. So the cost-benefit analysis should be done before you give your word. You need to weigh the benefits of giving your word against honoring that word. Yeah? Because when you give your word, what you're saying is that I will make it happen. Yeah? And so it is important that you understand. And that's why I think the good book says, I'm also a preacher, the good book says that be quick to listen and slow to speak. Because when you speak, then you need to keep your word. And for those who read the good book, you know that the same good book says that life and death is in your word. Even the creation we see today, for those who read the good book and who believe in it, it clearly says that God created everything. He spoke everything to being. He spoke everything to being. So your word is life. That is why you must think carefully before you speak. I don't know if there's anyone among us who has ever spoken something and immediately they are through with speaking. They are like, what did I say? Anyone? Remember to do some cost-benefit analysis before you speak. Because when you speak a word, then you have no choice but to honor your word. Yeah? Because if you don't honor your word, then you are untrustworthy and you are not a person of integrity. So when you don't honor your word, you become someone who cannot be trusted and someone who is out of integrity. Now there is something we call the law of integrity, the law of integrity. And the law of integrity states that as integrity declines, even the value of the person declines. Yeah? So, in other words, when you are out of integrity so often, people stop valuing you. I don't know whether you have friends who tell you something and you are like, I'll believe when I see you do it. You know? Yeah, someone tells you a lot of things, you're like, yeah, thank you, but I think let me see when you do it. It's because they don't trust you anymore. Yeah? Yeah? So when you violate that law of integrity, then the consequences can be very painful. Just the way you violate the law of gravity, you can imagine dealing with someone who never keeps their word, someone who is never moral, never ethical, never stands for anything. It's disaster. Yeah? So it is important for us to keep our word, because if we don't, then we're gonna have problems. The law of integrity. Maybe someone can type or tell us whether they have encountered in your own working place, in your own homes, have you encountered people that you no longer trust because of the way they have either not been honoring their word, the way they don't stand for anything? Anybody, you don't need to mention names, but have you come across such kind of people who never keep their word? They tell you, let's meet at 2, they come at 4, they tell you, this is Africa. You agree with each other, let's contribute this amount. They never contribute nothing, but when it is their turn, if you don't contribute, they are like, what is wrong with people? Anybody who has come across people like that? Anyone, you can raise your hand. You can just mention them, Saidi, I think, so that we move faster. Without integrity, nothing works. Now, it is good for us to note that people who have no integrity lose themselves. That's very important. If you have no integrity, you lose yourself. When you don't honor your word to yourself, because and to others, then you lose yourself. If you are a person of integrity, you are always at peace with yourself. Yeah? You are at peace with others. Sometimes people may even disagree with you, but you are at peace with yourself. You live without fear, yeah? Because you know what you say is so. You know what you say you will do. But remember, I said, if you're in a position where you are not able to do what you said, and you let the person know that you'll not be doing it, you still are a person of integrity. Because it is not always that you'll be able to do what you say you will do, yeah? So, when you are a person of integrity, there's no fear. You don't fear losing admiration of others. Yeah? You don't fear that people are going to, say things. So, why it is important for anyone to be a person of integrity is because you are at peace at yourself, you are at peace with everyone else. Yeah? Now, sometimes people mistake people of integrity for self-confidence. Yeah? So sometimes you hear people say that so and so is just self-confident, that's why they keep promising things and doing them. No. Basically, what you should understand is that you must keep your word, you must honor your word. Now, the next question is, what is the cost of lack of integrity? What is the cost of lack of integrity? Because almost all people, as one person said, and organizations, sometimes they fail to see the cost, yeah, when they don't behave in a certain way. They don't see the cost, for example, of calling a meeting where managers are seated and they are waiting for 1 hour and you have not arrived and you are the chairman of the meeting. Yeah? So it is important for us to ask ourselves, What is the cost of lack of integrity? Yeah? And that it is important that we understand that if an organization has people of integrity, they are likely to perform better. Yeah? In other words, when people have integrity, they are more productive. He is saying that integrity is this good, but just imagine if everybody kept their word. If everyone who is coming to, for the, I don't know what it is called in nursing, the one who is coming for duty comes on time, you leave on time. Because sometimes I hear my sister saying that this one was supposed to come at 8, they show up at 9:30. Just think, supposing everyone kept time. Supposing everyone kept their word where you work. I'm sure that you'll be more productive. So the question then is, what are those factors that contribute to lack of integrity? Why is it that people are always out of integrity? Why is it that people rarely keep their word? Why is it that people rarely stand for anything? Today you are, allow me to use politics, today you are in this party, tomorrow you are in another one, another day, another one. Why is it that people stand for nothing? Why is it that people are not moral, they are not ethical, they don't care about legal standards? So what are those factors that contribute to lack of integrity? Just for integrity, you're talking about being whole. You're talking about being in perfect condition. So if your car is not working, it is, doesn't have integrity. And that is the way we should think about ourselves. That if I am out of integrity, if I'm not keeping my word, what it means is that I am not in the, I'm not in the right condition for work, yeah? So sometimes people sacrifice integrity, yeah? So that even sometimes organizations can succeed. That is why people bribe, that is why people go and give money for tenders, that is why people give their friends tenders, because they are trying to sacrifice, thinking that integrity is just a virtue. But I want us to understand today that integrity is not just a virtue. Integrity is a condition that is necessary for performance. Yeah? Now, the other key thing that is important is that many times people are not aware that they are actually out of integrity. Yeah? They are not even aware they have not kept their word. Why? Because many of them give excuses. Many of them give reasons why they did what they did. Yeah? So sometimes people even lie, to themselves. Because they are not aware they're out of integrity. And I'm sure many of us today, I think sometimes there's that self-deception. When you tell someone that they're out of integrity because they did not keep time, they'll tell you there was a lot of jam. Many times that's what people tell you. There was a lot of jam on Mombasa Road. A lot of jam in Thika Road. But you see, a person of integrity will know there is normally jam. So you plan early, and there's someone who said poor planning. You plan early, then you leave early. So sometimes we deceive ourselves. We give reasons why we are lying. We rationalize things. We give excuses why we are doing the things that you're doing. For example, in Kenya, they'll tell you if you have to get business from government, you have to bribe, you have to know someone, you know, all those kind of stories. So sometimes we deceive ourselves. Now, the major factor, all what you have said is correct. I'm just adding now. One of the major factors that contribute to lack of integrity is the fear of acknowledging that you are not going to keep your word. Yeah? And if you check what you have said, stress, a lot of work, burnout, sometimes it's that fear that you're not going to keep your word. Yeah? So you want to avoid a threat. You see, if for example you're working and your supervisor comes and tells you something and you know you won't even do it, you're like, it's okay, we will try. Yeah? So that fear of acknowledging that you're not going to keep your word. And many people, not just in this nation, but all over the world, they fear that, you know, they just tell you it's okay. I don't know whether you have been in a situation where you don't want a lot of stories, you just say, well, it's okay, I'll do it. So the fear of acknowledging you're not going to keep your word. The other major factor is the fear of looking bad. You know, someone comes, asks you for money, and you don't have, and because you don't want to look bad, you tell them, wacha nitafute, nitakutumia maybe next week. But you actually know you will not do it. The fear of looking bad. Number three is the fear of losing power and respect. Yeah? So sometimes people be out of integrity or not keep their word because they want to retain their power and their respect. So they choose to have those short-term gains by, you know, hiding somewhere with their excuses and not keeping their word. Yeah? So sometimes that fear blinds us, and sometimes we don't keep our word because we fear. The other key factor, I'm just adding to what many of you have said, the other key factor that contributes to lack of integrity is because there are very few organizations, if any, that see integrity as a factor of production. Yeah? So sometimes people just see integrity just as a virtue. They never see it as a factor of production. And because of that, people are not, they don't, they are always out of integrity. The other key factor is we don't do the cost-benefit analysis as you give your word. Remember I had said earlier that it is always important to give or to do your cost-benefit analysis before you give your word. If I tell, for instance, if I promised that I'm going to be here and something happened, in fact, I'll tell you for sure that I yesterday I was very unwell, so I didn't even go to work, even this morning. But because I had promised your president that I'll do it, I just prayed, I told God, however bad I'll be feeling, I'll try and deliver. So sometimes we don't do the cost-benefit analysis of not as you give your word, yeah? You don't consider fully what it will take to keep that word, yeah? And in effect, when you give your word, sometimes people, actually most people are sincere, they are well-meaning, but they never think that actually they may not keep that word. So sometimes it is that irresponsibility of giving your word, which is a source of the mess in the lives of people, in the lives of organizations. I think I need to repeat that. That irresponsibility of giving people, giving words is what is creating the mess in many people's lives, in many people's, in many organizations, and even in government. You go, you tell people, I will do 1, 2, 3. You don't care whether you do it. You just create a mess. Yeah? The other key factor is when people start saying that talk is cheap. I don't know whether you have heard people saying talk is cheap. Yeah? In other words, people are saying, we are just talking, I was just kidding, I was just joking, you know? Yeah? So sometimes people are out of integrity because they don't have their word in existence when it comes to time to keep it. You said something, but it was not really in your mind because, as they say, talk is cheap.
Are you looking for a consultant, a trainer, or a motivational speaker? Well, look no further. Our team is competent in implementing team building and training programs for various clients. We work with you to identify your needs, assess your employees' skills design, and implement the most appropriate approach to deliver. Our approach is founded on a well-thought process, including a post-training phase and evaluation phase to assess the training. We are experts in team building, motivation talks, and matters of leadership and strategy. Call us and see the difference.